The Mesh Renderer. To render a mesh, we need two components, the Mesh Filter and the Mesh Renderer. When importing a mesh model, Unity will automatically create a prefab asset that includes a Mesh Filter component to hold the mesh data for the model, and a Mesh Renderer component to render this mesh data in our scene. The Mesh Renderer does not render skinned meshes. Skinned meshes are used for rendering characters. Characters are animated using bones, and every bone affects part of the mesh. If the model is skinned, Unity will create a skinned mesh renderer for the imported model instead. Information on skinned mesh renderers can be found in another lesson. Each mesh asset needs its own mesh filter and mesh renderer. If the model is made of several separate meshes, each will have its own prefab game object with its own mesh filter mesh renderer pair. The mesh filter holds the mesh data of the model and passes it to the mesh renderer for rendering on screen. The mesh filter component has only one property, and this is a reference to the mesh asset itself. The mesh renderer takes the mesh model data from the mesh filter and renders it in our scene at the position, rotation, and scale defined by the object's transform component. The mesh renderer has properties that define how the model will be rendered or drawn in our scene. These fall into three broad categories: shadows, materials, and light probes. With shadows, if there is a shadow casting light on the object, we can set whether the mesh renderer will cast and/or receive shadows. Next, there is a list of materials to render the object with. Unity needs at least one material assigned to the mesh renderer to be able to draw that object in our scene. For more information on materials themselves, see the appropriate lesson. Meshes imported into Unity can use multiple materials if the mesh model has been set up to do so in the original modeling application. The mesh renderer maintains a list, simply called materials, for all the materials used by the mesh model. Often this list only contains one material. This materials list should have one slot in the list for each submesh on the mesh model. If any given slot has no material assigned, the associated mesh will show pink, indicating that the material is missing. Lastly, there are light probes. A mesh can be lit by light probes. Light probes sample the lighting of a scene at a point and cast that light onto the rendered mesh. This is often used in conjunction with light mapping. Light probes light dynamic objects such as characters that would not receive baked lighting information from a light map. To use light probes, the Use Light Probes option must be enabled. For more information on light probes, including the Anchor Override property, please see the appropriate lesson and documentation link below.